has the letter K on it as well. That's an IDS. It's an information display system, and on there it shows you frequencies and sector IDs of neighboring airspace. Also weather for all the airports that you guys have control over.
We have an aerospace summer camp here.
And
we expose them to all sorts of things in the aerospace industry. Maintenance, the engineering, the piloting out at the flight school at the airport, and the air traffic control. And so today we got a group of kids here. They're doing a scenario in the tower, simulating Memphis International Airport. And so we're introducing them to the fundamentals of air traffic control, you know, taxiing the airplane from the gate to the runway, giving them the takeoff clearance, the landing clearance, the, you know, regulations on separation and all the rules that come with it. So they're really having a lot of fun in there today, I think.
Try one more time, just 696. Enter. There you go.
I do the air traffic control program, and so every day I do a lecture, and then they come to on Mondays they get a lecture on air traffic control and what it is and what it involves. And then each group comes here on every morning, and they get some hands-on experience doing air traffic control in a simulator. I think it was about 5 or 6 years ago that we started it. We've had a high enrollment ever since, and it's been a lot of fun for all of us involved. So we really enjoy doing it.
Giving them this firsthand experience on this is what the training is like for real students that want to become air traffic controllers as a career, you know, might open their eyes to, you know, wow, this is really something that I might want to do some more research on and pursue as I get older.